Good afternoon, guys. Hope for everyone. I'm audible to everyone, right? Guys, shall we start today's session? I guess it would be audible now, right? Okay, let's start today's session. Before entering today's session, we'll discuss about the quiz which happened on the T5. So we'll just see what is the quiz and we'll discuss that everything, so that we'll start with the class post this quiz discussion. Okay, so first is like the first question was, let me zoom in so that people you can see. So save option is available in, so anyone can tell me where save option will be there in Excel? Yes, see, if you go to Excel you can find the save option in there. See what option is there: ribbon, quick access toolbar, title bar, top bar. So you can find the save icon in the quick access toolbar. So the answer for the first one will be quick access toolbar. The second one will be, what is the shortcut to save a workbook? So kindly people answer this question. Okay, try to answer this. Varshini, hope I am audible now. Yes, it is control plus yes. So we have the options like control plus yes. Most people have chosen control plus save, but it is not a shortcut. The shortcut is control plus yes. Okay. So the third one is like if you choose a larger font size, the height of a row is automatically made taller. Okay, is this true or false? People kindly answer this. It is true or false? No, automatically Excel won't adjust itself. See, if you type something, if you type in bigger letter, okay, if you type in a bigger letter, see, changing this in a bigger letter, okay. See, Excel won't automatically adjust. It will adjust only that particular cell, okay. So what we are going to do is, the option will be false. See, okay, see, it doesn't automatically adjust its height and width, it just occupies the next cell. Okay, so for that, so the option will be false. Okay, so the next thing is very basic thing. The intersection of a row and column is called as, okay. So what will be the intersection of row and column called? So basically, an intersection of row and a column is called a cell. Okay, will be it's a very basic thing. It's a very basic thing, so everyone can understand that, right? So a column is called a intersection of column and row is called a cell. Okay, we have n numbers of cell. These n numbers of cell makes an Excel worksheet. Okay, and the next thing is a group of cell is called as what? Can anyone say me what is a group of cell called? Many people have said like it is a merge cell, so it is not a merge cell. Merge cell is like adding, like we are merging multiple cells into a single cell. That is a single command, but we call a group of cell as cell cluster. Okay, cell cluster. It is cell cluster. Where is the fill handle located? Okay, so if you navigate to the Excel worksheet, you can find fill handle. Okay, where we can find fill handle? Okay, so the option will be what the answer will be. In the bottom right corner of a selected cell. Okay. Yeah. So which button allows you to copy cell format from one cell to another? So we have a set of commands, okay, as we discuss here. If I want to take the entire cell format, like I have changed the format size, format colors and all everything. So what command will be using to copy the same format into that? Can anyone? Yes, it is format printer. And the second thing is formula in an Excel contains how many parts? We just saw in our PPT and I have shared that PPT too. A normal basic Excel formula has three parts, right? Yes, it is three parts. So the next thing, if at all we come, name of a cell will be in the format. You just can navigate, go to that Excel sheet. If you press and cell, its name will be displayed here. See, first it was A6, A column, sixth row. So it will be in the format of column into row. Okay. So what is the shortcut key for mixed reference? I just have said you, if you want to add a mixed reference, you can press F4. Okay. Sorry. See, I have written is equal to this into this. Okay, so enter, make it big. Okay, so if I go directly here, if I press F4, see, I can get this. See, if I press F4, it's asking whether I should give both dollar sign, then again, then it comes to row. And then it's again coming, it's coming to the column side. Okay, so F4 will be the shortcut for mix reference. Okay, so the formula to find average will be, what will be the formula to find average? This is very easy question. You can just go to there, you can write and type it here. It's equal to AVG. See, always it's coming, right? We can use AVG of, okay, sorry, average. If you write AV, its average is coming. We can double open it, we can set up, we can press set up things and we can do. Okay, then next thing is type of references in an Excel. We have how many reference types? So we have how many reference type in our Excel sheet? So anyone can guess that? Yes, we have three types. One is fixed reference, this is relative reference, and the third one is mixed reference. Okay, not two, it's three. Okay, how to retrieve a deleted worksheet? We just saw in a thing, we can't retrieve a deleted worksheet. We can retrieve deleted workbook from recycle bin, but we can't retrieve a deleted worksheet anymore. Okay, this is what the quiz questions. So we can see here, we got 223 people have attended. We got an average of 36.77, which is pretty good. Okay, so we got median marks also, 40% people were there. So I appreciate everyone who got above average. Okay, so obviously people got, many people got 55. Okay, I will release the score to them. Okay, so that you will get your scores. Okay, you will go to your mail. Okay, so the next thing is, okay, the next thing will be, we will be entering into the D7. We'll close it off this one. So before entering into D7, people are asking how to do permutations and combinations in Excel worksheet. Okay, so I will just show you. If at all you want to do any combination things or any combination formulas things, so that you can try yourself, you can try a permutation combination cell, how to do it, and you can submit it as today's assignment. Okay, so let me show you. If we have permutation and combination, we will take permutation. Permutation means what? N factorial by n minus 1 factorial, right? So I will just discuss with you how to write formulas. You people, as in today's assignment, you should submit that using you should submit your work using those formula. So let me tell you, let me add a sheet. Okay, so let me add a sheet. Okay, so if I want to what and all functions I'm using factorial, that's it, right? If I want to, if I have set of C, if I have five things, I want to arrange that elements into two. Suppose I have A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Okay, sorry, A, B, C, D, E. I have five elements. I want to combine everything in two sets. Okay, so how many combinations I will be getting? So used for that is equal to, okay, is equal to combination COM by com. If you write, you will get the command combine of these two. Okay, comma this one, right? You'll get 10 different combinations. Okay, so in the same wise you can write permutation also. See, is equal to permute of this comma this. See, I get 20 permutations. So instead of using those formulas, we can just do the permutation combination. We have predefined sets. Okay, so I think I'm audible now. Okay, the next thing. Okay, so this will be your assignment. Okay, so this will be your assignment as of day 7. So people are regularly submitting their assignments. The people who are not submitting, please do submit the assignments. Okay, so today, if at all you saw, we had given some, we got from Indersy for Python opportunity. So we just posted in group. People who are interested, they just came to us. We just directed them, so they will be getting those opportunity for. Okay, screen is little bit blur. No, I think screen isn't blur. Okay, you can just check your thing so that it is not blur. Yeah, let me zoom it in, but it's not blur. Plain check. Okay, it's not blur. So we'll enter day 7. Okay, so before entering day 7, we'll just quickly recap what we saw in day 6. We just saw, okay, let me delete it off. We just saw what is template and how to develop a template. Okay, let me open a whole thing. Day 3, see, we had developed a weekly fruit sale list. Okay, so what we did built it from a scratch. We just gave row labels, column labels, we filled the data as everything, and we found the percentage, everything according to that, and we built a template for our business. Okay, so if at all you want to multiply this for every week, you don't want to build it from very basic scratch. So what you will be doing is, you can just get this template, you can delete it of all the values, delete, you just click file, save as, and you can just click desktop. Day 3, instead of Excel workbook, if you click that button, Excel template will be there. So if you click that, the template get added. See, okay, so if at all you want to do the next week's thing, you just go on to this new. Instead of going to this featured, you can go to your personal thing, you can open things, this thing. See, you got the new, the same template which you have created, that is your personal template too, right? Okay, so this is what a template. So if we see what and all basic templates Excel might be having is seasonal calendar, basic personal budget will be there. We can just go to it. If you double click, it will get downloaded. You need an internet connection for that. So you will get see. So still commands are coming. I'll be using in this corner, so commands won't disturb your view. Okay. Okay, let it be. I guess it is fine. So people who see the commands also won't get disturbed. Okay, let me close this background stuff. See, in personal budget thing, we have set of common things. Okay. See labels, we have total expenses, cash out, etc. We have, okay, we have cash out, we have numbers of labels here, either row labels or common labels. Okay, so we'll just quickly see the rest of the things. Don't save, just we'll move on to the monthly budget. We just saw what is a template. A template is a predefined thing to fill in your data. Okay, so we'll move on to D7. Okay, D7, what we'll be seeing first is, let me close off this also. In D7, what we'll be seeing first is Excel list structures. Okay, please kindly note of that. The first thing is Excel list structure. Okay, until this day 6 class, everyone will be even they will be doing that in your day-to-day life. But from now onwards, if at all you do also, we have small changes which are very very important. So do note it, everything. Okay, so what we are going to do is Excel list structure. Okay, the first thing is, let me open this thing. Okay, list structure. Okay, let me open. Okay, I have this Excel. I will share this with this Excel at the end of this session. Okay, so you can practice it by yourself too. In all templates you can find, in all version you can find your template at when you are creating a new workbook. Okay, so see, the first thing, what is mean by Excel's list structure means, see, we have a set of rows and columns. These are set of collections of employers' IDs of an organization. Then we have B column, which bears last name of the individuals. Okay, so the third one will be the first name of the individuals, and then what department they belongs to, and then their email IDs, and then their phone extensions, their connections within the organization, and then in which location they are actually working in, and last we have what is their hire date, right? Okay, I guess it is audible now. Let me increase if you want. Okay, okay, so first what we are going to do is, first in this thing, let me just note it down everything. First we are going to give a command to Excel that if at all you want the data from this to this, this cell to this cell, up to Linda, you want to set the command, or you want to do an operation, means how to command the Excel prompt. Let's see first that. Okay, so if at all if I add, okay, I'm going to add a row here, right click, okay, insert, I'm getting added. Okay, if I go choose any one of the cell here, see, any one of the cell, and if I choose an option control plus A, select all, means it will select only this data. So what does we infer from here? So if at all we insert a row or a column, the Excel will automatically detect that it is a separate cluster of data, and this the After that new row, it is a separate cluster of data. If I select this, any cell, and Control A if I do, it will select these data will get collected. So Excel, what it does is, if we have an empty space, so it treat as two different clusters data. Okay. So this is what. So let me delete it off. I will come over again. If we have a set of datas and you want certain datas, like you want first top 10 datas to be calculated or interpreted in your thing, and you don't want that rest data, means just insert a row or a column so that Excel will automatically detect its thing as a two separate cluster of datas. Okay. So this is what we called as data clustering or data naming to the Excel. Okay, the second thing will be, what we'll be seeing is sorting a list using single level sort option. So what is meant by sorting? See, if I have a set of values, okay, I am having numbers from 1 to 3, okay, 1, 3, 5, 6, 4, like this, okay. If I want to sort in ascending or descending order, I will choose these cells. I'll go navigate to the data tab. See, I can find here either I want to ascend it smallest to largest or largest to smallest. Okay, so I can press this. See, it get aligned. Let me zoom in. See, it get aligned from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. It got shorted out. Okay, so in the similar way, if I do the other thing, like short from largest to smallest, if I click that, see, 6, 2, 4, 3, 2, 1. This is what we called as single level short. We are shorting a single level data. Only with help of one data, we are going to short it down. Okay, so see, if we have data from an organization, how to interpret with single level shorting. Okay, so let me delete it off this first. Delete. Okay, wait, let me do this so that comments won't hide you. I think it will be more visible now. See, if I want to sort the data based on their names, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to sort based on the names. Okay, so I'm going to do single level sorting here first. So I will just click this sort from A to Z. See, now it is already sorted. Okay, so let me sort it from Z to A, bigger value to smaller value. I sorted this column, this single data. Okay, so this is called single level sorting. According to that, these and all got changed. See, Z, V, Y, W, V, it got sorted based on the descending order. Okay, so I'll again sort it on ascending order. Okay, this is what we called. See, we are sorting with using a single data. We are only sorting based on last name. Okay, this is what we called as sorting with single level sorting. Okay. So the next thing will be, is everything clear about single level sorting? Many people will be using single level sorting. Okay. Yes. See, to do a command, we have multiple things. Okay. We have command we can do here. Sorry, in data tab we can short it here. Else, we in your home tab we can short it here. See, we can short Z to Z, Z to A, custom. We'll be seeing. So we have many. It's user friendly, right? So we have multiple areas to get access. Okay. The second thing is, what we are going to see is sorting with multi-level sorting. Okay, so see, people will be shorted out. See, if at all in my class, two Mohammed is there. If I want to do an attendance order, then what will be, I'll be seeing Mohammed. Okay, then what the next name coming, the first name what he has. So I'll be shorting them in that manner. Okay, so if I have two Mohammeds, I'll then I will go for shorting them with this first name. So let me see, one has Ahmed and one have name starting with B, then I will obviously choose A in the first and the B in the second, right? In the same manner, this is what we are going with a multi-level shorting. For that, what we are gonna do is, see, let me for multi-level shorting, see, you can choose any cell because it is multi-level, right? So we just go to here, short. So short windows got popped up. Okay, so first what we are going to do, so first we'll check on last name. Okay, we'll set the things on last name. So we short by last name and short on values, what values we have, and short them from A to Z. Okay, then we'll click add another level, then short based on first name, values A to Z. See, now see, I have Albert down. See, if I have both Berwick, that E, then it comes to this first name. So E will come obviously before yes, no, so it's shorted based on that. See, if I have two Coopers, then two Lindas, it will be having the same order which we had before. Okay, so see, we had two Corvick, obviously J comes before R, so we have J there, right? You guys are getting, so you just got to know what is single level shorting and multi level shorting, right? See, well, let me do it again. So we'll short on another data also. We'll short it. See, we'll short. We'll delete this level. We'll short by employer ID, or we'll just short by seniority values, oldest to the newest. So oldest people have more priority in an organization. Then if more people are hired in the same dates, then we'll add a level based on their department. Okay, department values A to Z. See, both people joined in 8th September, but based on their departments, okay, they also same. So what previously we had given, the same thing will be happening. So what we are going to do, we'll use short again. So instead of departments, we'll based on first name, okay? So A to Z. Now see, they have first name same too. So we'll do other thing. I think the both the things are same values. Yes, it is same values. So you just got to know, right? So yes, I will come over again the multi-level shorting. Okay, so multi-level shorting is like, if you have single data and if you want to short according to that, see, example, you have a set of people and their ranks, okay? You want to short only based on rank, it is like single level ranking, okay? Single level shorting actually. So, but if you want to short based on two criterias or two or more criterias, that is called a multi-level shorting. So what we are basically doing is, so we go navigate to data tabs and shorting. Okay, then we give what and all commands we want. First we based on first last name values A to Z, and first name values A to Z, then I give S, so it get automatically shorted. First A and all will come, then B and all will come, so according to that it will get changed. Okay, suppose if I have two names, okay, two Berwicks are there, then automatically it moves to the second shorting method. So it will check the first name, which one have first, this F is okay, sorry, if it will come, see, these both have same Berwick, right? So it jumps to the second criteria where E is comes first, then yes, so it will short E first and then yes first. Okay, kindly check your internet connectivity because we don't face any trouble from our side. So okay, so the next thing what we are going to see is we are going to use a custom chart. Okay, so for that let me go to other tab. See, I just forgot to say you like other option to go to different tabs. Okay, different worksheets, we have another option. See, we have arrow marks here, right? We just right click it, we have things. See which option you want to go. Okay, let me go this. Just a second. Summary, customer info. Okay. See, you'll be using this, okay? So we are going to do custom shorting. First, what we saw, single level shorting, we can use either A to Z or 1 2 3. Based on that we can do in doing first level one single level shorting. So we just saw how to do multi-level shorting. We just gave multiple criterias to short the datas. So we just move on to the topic, how to use a custom shorting method. Okay, for that we will be using this template. Okay, so we'll just go navigate to the data tabs, and under short and filter, obviously you can choose this short here. See, I want to short based on month. Okay, if I say values A to Z, if I create this. Okay, see, from April is coming, August is coming, then February. Based on the alphabet it is shorting, not I just want based on the month, January, February, March, April, May, like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a custom short. See, month, values, add a custom list. So basically Excel have 4 custom lists. Okay, so based on weekdays, Sunday, or this SUNDAI, like that, full letter or a half letter, or the same way the month wise. Okay, so I'll just click this month, I'll click okay. Now let me check. See January, February, March, April, according to the month it gets shorted away. So like that you can give your own custom thing. See, you can add your custom list. You can add some custom things also. See, list of entries, what and all should come first, what and all you should be doing. Okay, so this is what we called as custom list. Okay, so kindly please note it down everything so that it might be useful in your future. So what is mean by single level shorting, what is mean by multi-level shorting, how to do that, and how to do custom shortings. Okay, I'll give you a couple of minutes so that you people can note it down what and all we did. Okay, so these are all basics for level 2. Since we are in 7th day, we are now preparing for the level 2. Okay, so level 2, since we have a short duration time, exactly 40 days, we just want to bring it up everything. So just cover all basics very promptly. So just now we saw what is custom shorting. Okay, ओके ओके सो देन द नेक्स्ट थिंग व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू इज सी इफ आई सोल्ड अ सेट ऑफ ओके इफ आई हैव एन डिजिटल प्रोडक्ट सेलिंग कंपनी ओके सो आई हैव सोल्ड अ सेट ऑफ बुक्स सेट ए बुक्स फॉर दिस मच रुपीज फॉर दिस मच क्वांटिटी आई हैव चोज लाइक दैट आई एम राइटिंग डेली अ नोट्स और सम अकाउंट्स टू दैट ओके सो आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू शॉर्ट इट आउट हाउ मच डेट हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ सम सर्टेन प्रोडक्ट्स हैव बीन सोल्ड एंड आई वॉन्ट टू सम इट अप ओके सो फॉर द बेसिक थिंग एज फार एज वी सॉ नाउ वी वॉट विल बी डूइंग विल जस्ट गो हियर विल शॉर्ट इट ए टू जी Right, so we'll get the datas. So this much things I have sold, chocolate chips and fudge brownie I have chosen. Okay, so if I want to sum it up, so what I'll be doing is we'll be inserting a row. Sorry, here we'll be inserting a row. We'll do is equal to sum of these. Sorry, is equal to open the brace sum of these enter. Okay, we'll be doing like this, right? We'll just manually add it up everything sum of these two, these enter. We'll be doing that, so we'll be getting the total, right? So in that we can do like this, we can do go and do individual things if we have very less quantity of things. Okay, so if we are running a big business in an organization point of view, so what you have to do is you can do one thing. See, control Z, let me undo what I did. See, I'll select the datas. Okay, I'll select all datas. I'll navigate through data tab. Okay, I'll navigate to data tab. In that, you can find at last. See, we move over the right corner, have subtotal. Okay, if you click this, see, it is asking at each change in cell. Okay. Yes, it change in cell uses some function. You can add, you can count how many count you have, how many product you have sold. You can see average, maximum which price, minimum which price, what product we have sold, like that. Okay, so now we've not sum. Okay, sum and add subtotal. Okay, you add to subtotal. Okay, so subtotal will be adding. See, okay, see. A mango D Camrose total, in total he was selling 825. Okay, we get individual subtotal. See, let me explain you again. Class this subtotal. Okay, see, for chocolate brownies what I have sold in my company is 4700, and let me zoom it in, $83. So same way, fudge brownie is $7,831. The same way I got grand total, including grand total what my thing is there. So this is what we called as creating subtotal in a list. We will be having, organization will be having set of list like their sales things and all. So we can short it out and we can subtotal it. We can give results what and all the sales was there, what the whether the target has been achieved or not. So yes, we can do that. Okay, so people kindly note it down. I have zoomed in, right? Just you can check now. See, we get grand total actually You just noted down what we all we discussed. Now we'll see. I will repeat it again. You people are asking. Let me repeat it again. Okay. See, if I am running an chocolate business. Okay. Let me take an example of I am running a chocolate business. So a customer is coming and buying an chocolate. Okay. So he is buying. Let me take a TV. I am selling a TV. Okay. Let first customer is coming and getting a brand from a TV from Lenovo. Lenovo. Okay. So he bought for rupees 500. Okay, so other person coming, he is buying at TV at Sony. He gave me 1000. Okay, so other person is coming, he is coming and getting Lenovo. He is giving price, he bargained and got it for 485. So other person is coming and buying Lenovo again, but this time I sell some more profit for me and I am getting 510 rupees. Okay, so now at the end of the day I should choose. Okay, I want to see how much amount of TVs I have sold, at what brand I have sold, at what in this brand how much I sold. So what I'll be doing, I'll just make a list. See, let me short it out first, A to Z. So just get sorted out. Then what I'm going to do, I'm going to subtotal it. Lenovo, okay. See, Lenovo, I have sorry. This custom pops up because we have used, okay. We have used, what to say, we didn't use any title and all, so it's get popped up. Please reevaluate your data like that. So what we'll be doing is, so Lenovo, we bought Lenovo, we bought the, we got a sold of this some value, right? And then Sony, we had only one sale, that is 1000 rupees. So in total, I, in my shop, I have made a sale for this much amount, and individually I can get also. See, these three I have sold for Lenovo and this one for Sony, right? In the same manner, if you consider a bigger organization, they'll be having set of clustered data, so they'll be doing here and there. Okay, so they have unsorted data, and at the end of the day, the marketing people, what they want to do is, like, they want to check whether the sale, targeted sale, have been achieved, and in which areas and all they have been less or more, like that they want to do. So what they will does is, so let us short this everything first based on this. Okay, so when we short this, we got, see, what and all, first chocolate chips, how much chocolate chips we sold, then brownie, what, how much brownie we sold, then strawberry flavored, how much we sold, like that we got sorted out. Now we don't want to go to everything and we want to subtotal it. Instead of that, what we can do is, we can select everything, select the datas. Okay, you can go to the data tab. Data tab, see, subtotal will be there. You can see at each range in chocolate chips, everything, right? So get okay. See, chocolate chips, a row got added. So how much chocolate chips in total I have spent? Sorry, subtotal. See, chocolate chip, a total I have sold for $4,783. In the same way, chocolate brownie I have sold for, in total I have spent sold for 7,831. Strawberry in total I have spent for approximately 9,000. In the same way, rest all also get calculated, and at last we got how much grand total we had made. So in organization point of view, we can easily identify where and all our target got lagged or it got increased like that, so that they can improvise their performance in future, and also they can grand total it. It see, we had some set of 45 datas, okay, 46 datas. So in an organization point of view, which have multinational branches, they will be having crores and crores of data. So it will be very, in a fraction of a second, you can sort it and you can get the values, okay. So the next thing what we are going to do is, we are going to format as datas. Now we just saw how to format everything, right? Okay, let me do in this only. Okay, now we just saw individual subtotaling of individual datas and the subtotaling of overall things, right? So the last thing will be, okay, the last thing will be formatting as data. I just want a particular data, okay. For that I'll go into the first thing, okay. So we people will understand, not this. Okay, let me choose this. Okay, it is fine for me. Okay, we'll format as data. Okay, now what we are going to do is, I just want what I want. Now I want to see only for the month of January, rest all I don't care at all. Okay, so what I'm going to do is just select everything. Go to format table, okay. See, if you choose, it will ask from this to this, okay. So we can format this entire data as in the form of table, okay. So we just sorted this in a form of table. Now I just want to see only the January month's sales, okay. So what I'm going to do is, I have a button here, the month. I give select all, unselected. I'll just select January and then okay. See, I get only January month sales, okay. In the same way, if I want only, see, I'll select all every month, okay. And if I want only south region, unselect all south region only, okay. See, I get only south region. What are the sales have been got in south region, like that, okay. So this is what we call formatting of datas. Using datas we'll be formatting the sales. So actually I'm asking you, people want this Excel format to be shared in the group, or you will create by your own, getting from internet, and you will submit to me. You can just get it from internet, or you can get it from me, whichever it will be easy for you. You can ask me, I will share with you. You can practice so that. I guess only for 20-30 people are discussing in the forum. Actually, I get pretty good names like Meenakshi or something, Varshini, Varsha. Those names and all I'm getting frequently. I request everyone to be active in the forum. I just said you why we have access to the forum. So just make use of that forum and excel yourself, okay? Yeah. For those who want, I'll send this in the group. For people who are creating their own, it's far far better. I appreciate it actually, so that you are, I can know your involvement in that. So I'll be sharing. People who want to practice in this, they can practice and they can send it to me, but don't send in a blend. Just however you are getting, you don't send me back like this. I just want something innovative. I just think something and you get it. Guys, if you have any doubt, you can ask now. We'll try wind up today's session. After that, I will be telling you that session ID. If you have any doubt, you can just ask me. See, combinations, why we want to use is like, see, if at all you have set of things, you might be studied in your class 10 or 12, right? So what will be, if we have two things, some set of things, you want to combine two things in a set. So what will be a set of combinations will be there. So industrial point of view, why they will be using this, they will be using for people to contact. Okay, so we have set of people. Okay, so set of marketing agents will be there. So based on their performance, we should combine them, and we should see probability how much people they can cover, or how much people they can interact, and whom and all they should contact. So that we'll be getting the set of combinations, and we'll be working out in that. See, formatting is nothing but just check. Sorry, formatting is nothing but you want a selected data of things to be shown, and you want to select a particular type of data. You just click everything, you just select all data, go to format as table. You can just format it as a table. Okay. So once you format it as table, you can find drop down buttons in your headings. So base, if you click that, you can just select which thing you want. Just I will select, and then I'll select only West. Then if I click OK, so West data only will be shown. Okay. The permutation actual formula is n factorial number of variance we have by n minus r factorials. Okay, so instead we have inbuilt thing in our Excel, which is equal to, if you write permutation permute, you will get permute. Okay, so you can choose this, and you can read which and all values you want, and you can choose this. So permutation, comma will come. Why it is coming means, see, just check permut of these two values. See, permut of 2 and 5 you will be getting around 60, right? If you at all you give this much big value, it's saying it's a bigger number, it can't be shown here. Okay, let me say permut of just a value of 2 and then 10. Sorry. Permit of this, comma, sorry, this, Oh, it's saying hash number. So we have, see, we have predefined data, so we don't can't do an order into predefined data. See, if I give a 5 and 10, and you can do permute dat because it is an independent value. Permute of 5, comma, and then 10 will fetch you the value. Sorry, oh, it is giving error. So actual formula for permuting is PERMUT. See, if you depend on Excel, okay, so you don't want to just remember what are all formulas for which thing. If you just type the thing, you can easily find it out. Okay, so today's session ID will be is you can do table formatting, but if I want to display only set of data, okay, see, if you have only a certain limit of things, you can short it out and do things. Okay, so if you have multi crores of data and if you want to short them under a category and if you want to display it, it will be preferred. See, we are just going organization point of view. What we are teaching, what we are showing example is just you people to understand. So in level 3 we'll be working on how the organization really does. Okay, so today's session ID will be 844469. Sorry, 844469. So multi-level sorting is like nothing but if you want to sort two variables based on two variables, we'll be using multi-level sort. See, go to data tab, sort based on two things. First one is year and then next one is month. If I sort this, see, first based on month alphabetical order and then based on the year. Okay, so if you want to have two variables, two things, if you want to compare, you can just create like that. Okay, we have provided that Google form, right? You can submit in that 844469. People don't get share this in the group so that people who might not attend the class can attend, can write this thing. Okay, it's 844469. You just select everything. If you want to become it as an original form, you select everything. Let me choose this again. You can select everything, go to home tab, format it as table, clear table style, whole table. Okay, see, everything got cleared. You can add this table actually. See, we can find difference here. You can delete it off actually. See, you can delete this thing. And you can do, see, clear all formats. Everything got cleared, right? There are two other ways, okay. So guys, we'll finish this session off. Assignment, what we have practiced today, I just want everyone to do along with permutations and combinations, okay? It's 8444, so you can see here, it's 8444 69. Okay guys, thank you. Assignment I have said, right? You just want to pre-create your own content in the form of whatever we saw. We should sort it out, everything. Okay. And also do permutations and combinations. Thank you everyone. Thank you. So I'll be sharing that crazy document. This document will be sharing the group. Yeah, but making buttons in each row doesn't matter, right? But doesn't make any sense. You just create your own data and do permutations and combinations, okay? So the people who applied for this campus ambassador, they will be having their meet at 7 o'clock, okay? Do attend that. Okay guys, you can leave the session. And today's assignment is like we want to practice whatever we do today, shorting everything that and that you should be doing that. Then permutation and combination, you try something and upload in that Google form. So thank you everybody. I'll be sending this link in the group so that you can revise it. Thank you.